Today I'm going to go over my first impressions of Aliens Fireteam Elite, and we're going to start right now. What's up guys, Reckless here, welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to talk to you guys about my experiences with Aliens Fireteam Elite. And if you guys want to see more Aliens Fireteam Elite content in the form of class builds, experience farming, official and fan main lore, news updates and more, be sure to subscribe down below and turn on notifications so you never miss out on any videos. So, for starters, for those who don't know me, I'm Reckless. I do a lot of videos on Outriders, Godfall, Destiny 2, and now Aliens Fireteam Elite and Back 4 Blood upon release. The gameplay in the background is actual gameplay and not gameplay of the alpha or beta. Now, I am completely new to this game. I played a little bit of Aliens Colonial Marines and a little bit of Alien Isolation. Aliens Fireteam Elite is not like those games at all. This game has done the Alien franchise justice in so many different ways that Colonial Marines messed up. But let's go ahead and get into what this game actually is, the things that I like about the game, the things that I don't like, and what I feel can be changed in a patch or an update to improve the game. First off, Aliens Fireteam Elite is not like Aliens Colonial Marines at all. It is so much better in so many ways. It is not Alien Isolation either. However, these three are different games with different types of experiences. If I were to compare Alien Fireteam Elite to a different type of game, it would have to be something like a Left 4 Dead, but not. While yes, there are some Left 4 Dead aspects, there are tons of things that make this game a far stretch from Left 4 Dead, and I can say a lot of great things about this game. For starters, Aliens Fireteam Elite is a cross-gen game. It is currently not cross-play or cross-save. Cross-gen means that you can only play it on the same platform as other people. So, for example, PS4 and PS5 players can play together, as well as Xbox Series X and S can play with Xbox One players, and Steam members can play with each other. This game is a three-player co-op. You can play this game online with friends or by yourself with two bots. However, I wouldn't recommend that. One thing that sets this game apart from other games like Left 4 Dead is that there are 20, yes, 20 different enemy types of xenomorphs. There are 5 classes in the game, but only 4 are available to be chosen as of this video. Those classes are Gunner, Demolisher, Technician, and Doc. The last class that is currently unplayable is called Recon. Each class has 2 abilities that have cooldowns, 2 primary weapons, a sidearm, 30 weapons in total, 4 different campaigns with 3 missions in each campaign. Now, the character customization isn't the best in the world, but it has a lot of options compared to other games where they give you a pre-made character and say good luck. When it comes to the character's base appearance, you can customize your toon's archetype, not sex, whether you be feminine or masculine, and I actually like how the devs worded that. You can customize your face with 10 different options. There are 7 different skin tones and eye colors, 16 different hairstyles, 8 different facial hairstyles, 18 different hair colors, and 6 different voices. But customization doesn't just end there. You have tons of options for head accessories as well as outfits, both of which you can unlock in-game via credits or hidden caches. As for the gameplay, we do get a motion tracker like the ones in the movies. There is a cover mechanic where you can hide and shoot from cover as well, and jump over cover as long as it's on the same ground on the opposite side. So, for example, you can jump over some cover that are boxes or crates on the floor, but if there is a drop on the other side, you won't be able to. There is no friendly fire on the default difficulty, but you can change the difficulty and friendly fire will get enabled. If you are anything like me, you should take your time and explore the game on your first run through. There are hidden caches all over the game on each mission. These hidden caches unlock new weapon perks, attachments, gives you items for your inventory, etc. Besides hidden caches, you also have intel on the missions, and most missions have a lot of intel scattered around the mission. Unfortunately, intel isn't as easy to see as the hidden caches. A lot of the intel are small objects that will only light up when you are right up on it. However, do not go anywhere in this game alone. You will be attacked by multiple xenomorphs, and they will continue to attack you if you don't move with your team. With all of the hordes of xenomorphs coming at you anyways, it's just better just to stay with your team. The challenge card system is an interesting thing in this game, and very easy to understand. Each challenge card has a different mini objective that you need to complete. These challenge cards have different rarities on them from common, rare, epic, and I'm not sure if there is a legendary challenge card as of this video. I have not seen one yet, and if there is one, it probably won't be available until later on in the game or at a harder difficulty. Each challenge card has a mini objective that you need to complete. After completing these mini objectives, you gain extra experience, credits, and some challenge cards actually give you nothing except the satisfaction of having twice as much ammo or twice as much health. But you will normally see those types of objectives on common challenge cards, which are green. If you have a 3-member fire team, when you start a mission, each member can pick a challenge card that they have in their inventory, and the game will randomly choose one of the 3 challenge cards, and that will be the challenge for that mission. The other 2 cards that did not get chosen will be put back into the owner's inventory, and they can try to use them on the next mission. However, if you fail a mission and everyone dies, that challenge card for that mission that was activated will get consumed, and you do not get the bonus, and you will not get that challenge card back. Now, let's go ahead and go over the 4 classes real quick to give you guys a little bit of understanding on each class. First up, we have the Gunner. The Gunner is a mid to long range class that is all about rapid fire, being adaptable, and focuses on assault. They use rifles and close quarter weapons, or CQW. Their abilities are called Overclock and Frag Grenade. Overclock allows gunners to give their fire team's weapons increased rate of fire. Demolishers are also mid to long range and are all about disrupting the enemy, area damage aka AOE, and assault. They use rifles and heavy weapons like smart guns, flamethrowers, etc. Their abilities are micro rockets that launch 3 rockets and detonate them on impact, and blast wave that damages enemies and is also a knockback. Technician, which is the class that I actually started the game out with, is a close to mid-range class and focuses on turrets, zone control, and is pretty much a defensive class. They use handguns and CQWs. Their abilities are Sentry Turret, which deploys a sentry turret, and Charged Coils, which is a device that shocks the enemies and slows them down. And the last class is the Doc. They are the close to long range fighter due to the weapons that they use, like handguns and rifles. They specialize in healing, support, and being defensive. Doc's abilities are Trauma Station, which helps heal the fire team in a small AoE, and then there is also Combat Stims, which also increase your accuracy and stability by 50%, your stamina regen by 30%, and movement speed for you and nearby allies by 15%. At the moment, not much is known about the Recon class, except that you can buy outfits for them in-game. Overall, this game is amazing and so much fun to play either with friends or, need I say, even with bots. The gameplay is great, the enemies can be unpredictable at times, it's not too hard and it's not too easy either. It has a terrible balance of fun and frustration, but in a good way. Mostly frustration if you are not playing your role. For example, you can't be a doc trying to kill everything without healing. It's just not gonna work. But Aliens Fireteam Elite is not without its faults. There have been times where some of your abilities weren't working at all. There have been times where the sound of your weapons that you were firing wasn't actually happening. There have been times when one of our members was completely useless because he couldn't fire his weapon, reload, change weapons, or use his abilities. He was just Xenobait. Ooh ha ha. Sorry for the Finding Nemo reference. There were times where connection was an issue, and there were times when, if you change the settings, they weren't even saving, even though it's supposed to automatically save. While these are issues that other people had, I had just a few small issues with my cosmetics, like not showing correctly. But that's like the only issue I had. After downloading the game upon its release at midnight, I actually played the game for about 2 hours before heading to bed. When I woke up to an update for the game, which was awesome because that lets us know that the devs were on top of things. And then again, when I came back from lunch in the afternoon, and then again, while I was actually writing this script. Stuff like this is why this game will survive in the long run, because that means that the devs are actually paying attention to the feedback that the players are giving them. And because of that, I really love this game, and I recommend it to anyone who is and is not a fan of the Alien franchise. This game has outdone every Aliens game prior to it, regardless of the genre that it was. Not to mention all of the extra stuff that the devs have planned for the deluxe edition of the game. I mean, look at all of the difference from the standard version of the game to the deluxe. I don't know about you, but anytime there is extra stuff, it's a good thing. This game is only $40 for the standard version, and that is on every platform that it's available on, and it is well worth the money. I personally probably would have paid for the game even if it were $60. Unfortunately, my game time with this game had been limited to when the kids actually go to bed. I, like a responsible parent, don't play video games that are violent when my kids are around. But I will get in as much gameplay as I can when the kids are not around. I can say that I do feel very, very confident when it comes to doing content for this game on my channel, because it really is an amazing game, and I am glad that I actually made this investment. Yes, gaming is an investment. A couple of things that I actually forgot to mention about this game is that, one, the game sound is perfect, just like if it came straight out of an Aliens movie. I mean, from the sound that the Xenomorphs make to the background to the soundtrack, it's just all around amazing. Then there are tons of jump scares in this game that just immerses you into the game like if you were actually there. And then last but not least, you can actually skip all of the beginning credits and get straight into the game within like 15 seconds of starting the game, or at least that's what it is for PC. I'm not entirely sure if you can do that on console as well. Now, I play Aliens Fireteam Elite on my PC, so if you guys actually play it on the PC, or you would like to get the game for the PC, and you would like to group, by all means, let me know down in the comments section with your Steam ID, and then we can get together. As I play more of this game, I will give you guys my recommendations on class builds, which include weapons, attachments, and perks to maximize the potential of your class, so stay tuned. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. If you play Outriders, go ahead and join the Everything Outriders Discord. All platforms are welcome. You can make new friends, we host free carries for every expedition and Eye of the Storm, get detailed information such as data mines, patch notes, lore, and we also host free modder lobbies with high restrictions as well. We have well over 1,600 members, and it is growing every day, so come and join us. A link to the Discord will be in the description box below, and I will see you guys in the next one.
Hey, hey you, watch these videos too. I know you like them. Go.